So it's Women's History Month, and one of the things that I know it specifically is in your focus is finding out the reasons of why lung cancer happens in specifically women who are non-smokers. Is that correct?
Correct. That's correct.
That's really fascinating because we always associate smoking with lung cancer, but you actually are focusing
right.
on non-smokers in women. So
right. So we, when I arrived here, we started what we think is the second women's lung and health center, probably in the world, but definitely in the United States, with sort of the recognition that there are some gender disparities in a lot of different aspects of pulmonary disease. My specific area of interest in this is lung cancer. The basic epidemiology of lung cancer is that 85% of non-small cell lung cancers occur in smokers.
Oh, really?
15% occur, however, in non-smokers. This is the number one cancer killer for both men and women. When you look at that 15% of non-smokers who get lung cancer, two-thirds of them are women. No one has any idea why. There's lots of speculation regarding either environmental toxins, possibly a hormonal component, but all of it's pure speculation. It's really an area that's been under-researched. So what we're trying to focus in on here is creating some research and clinical programs around this issue. Of course, the Women's Lung Center is bigger than just lung cancer,
right?
Because these disparities exist in other problems, such as bronchiectasis, COPD, and asthma, and interstitial lung disease. We've actually assembled a great multidisciplinary team here. You know, the members are Kathy Hsu, who's a medical oncologist, Angela Domingo, who's one of our pulmonologists who focuses on bronchiectasis, Keith Brenner, who focuses on COPD and asthma, and Nina Patel, who focuses on interstitial lung disease. And so we're all in the process of building this center up to really provide integrated care that's sensitive both in terms of treatment, but also developing research programs towards women who have pulmonary disease.
That's amazing. What do you hope in the next 5 years? Do you hope that you kind of figure out some things? Like what's your hope?
The hope is to help understand, at least for me, why non-smokers are more likely to be women when they get lung cancer.
Wow.
What we know about those patients is that unfortunately they present with later stage disease. However, they tend to live longer despite presenting at a later stage. So there's something about the biology of these patients that we just don't know. So 5 years from now, 10 years from now, what success would look like to me is identifying who these patients are and trying to identify them earlier. You know, for example, in breast cancer, we know that there are the BRCA genes. Does that exist for lung cancer? We don't know.
Mm-hmm.
It may not, but it's something that we would like to try to look into. So it would be great if in the future we had a screening protocol for patients who we identified either by clinical characteristics or genetic characteristics that are high risk at getting lung cancer, even though they don't smoke.
Mm.
So that would be, you know, sort of the holy grail for us.
The holy grail. Dr. Stanifer, thank you.
All right, thanks.
Thank you.